That's factory, dude.
That is not factory.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, machines and machine freaks. I hope you guys are feeling extremely froggy fresh because I sure am, and the Jeep probably is not. He is or she is currently turbocharged though, and that's pretty fly. I wanted to make a video that takes my mind and puts it into a video of kind of where this Jeep is going to go. You guys know I back in the day I wanted to build a super cool gator. Yeah, so I've always been into like weird kind of stuff. Stuff you can't necessarily buy in the store. I don't know why I'm hanging out of this pen. Stuff you can't buy in the store. Stuff you have to kind of take from this, take from that, put it all together and make something cool. And that, machines and machine freaks, is how I came up with the Brat Board. Yeah, that half skateboard, half ripstick, half motorized contraption, that thing. Strangely enough, I have some stuff in the mail for that thing. Upgrade, so to speak, but we'll get to that later on. Now going back to the gator thing, this thing is going to be our new gator, and our new gator could use a lot of new parts, including a new gas tank. We really don't need a new gas tank. However, I would like to replace this fuel pump. I would also like to replace this rusty, crusty fill spout.
Those two are definitely going on the list.
Basically, I have a huge pool right here, and the only way I can fill that pool is with one of these at a time. It's gonna take a while, but we're gonna have a lot of fun doing it. Like, we can invite our friends and party it up and stuff while we're filling up this pool. I can also lose my grip on a wrench and break my knuckles open. So we're definitely gonna have a blast. A lot of people can already envision this, and they're saying that this thing's going to be a beast. We're gonna go one notch further than that. We're gonna make this thing a machine. I'm basically planning for war. I have to document everything that has to go into this, everything that I have to get on top of that, what procedures need to happen to make those parts go. It's going to be a big, long process. I'm going to enjoy every second of it. That's all there is to it. So let's start checking this thing out. So as you can see, there are some really, really good spots of this Jeep, of this frame, the way things were done. And there's also some spots that it was just the shortcuts were taken. The reason why the gator never got accomplished were a couple things. And one of the main reasons I'm putting this new fuel tank holder. The gator was literally like five different machines. We had a motorcycle engine, we had like a UT, what do you even call that thing? A five-wheeled whatever. And there was gonna be a few more other vehicles that were going to be needed to make that thing happen. Basically what it was we had a huge amount of horsepower, but we had a vehicle that had a transmission that could not handle it. And the technology and hardware needed would have been way, way inefficient. Well, that's something I overlooked. I just got really, really excited about it. This thing is different. Now, it could have gotten done with enough parts and enough money, but by the time we put those two things in, we basically would have had a crush. I like crush way better than that gator would have ever been. I think that's the rest of the gator stuff. If you have any other questions, leave them in the comment section below. Otherwise, we're moving the excitement and all the awesomeness to the Jeep. And when you need parts for something like this, you don't have to go find five other vehicles. You just kind of go on Google and say, hey, I need a 97 Jeep part.
First, you're kicking my butt.
Alright, see these two nuts here? These hang on to this shock. I'm not going to use this shock, but it's going to hold the future shock. Now over here, I cut those right off.
And I'm sure you saw the reason why before. Well, that one's drilled right through and the original bolt's still in that nut.
And then the other nut was just shot, so we're gonna start from scratch. When you're MIG welding, you gotta have everything really clean. I'm gonna show you how to do that with these things.
Now that this is all cleaned up, I see what I'm working with. This bolt is actually still in there.
Now I'll just punch that remaining bolt out with a hammer. I do have to give a big thanks to True York, the flap disc company. There will be a 10% off coupon in both the description and the comment section. They are going to help us out with this Jeep project, so I appreciate that. I think you'll agree with me when I say I'll probably use a couple of these. Random Jeep question time. What is that mount right there?
Yes, next to the thing that looks like a monkey took a crap on it. This thing right here. Anybody know what that is? Leave it in the comment section below right now.
Reaction time?
You don't like the angle of that?
No.
That's factory, dude.
That is not factory.
What is that? That's a monkey escaped from the zoo, had a good time, and then took a dump right all over that thing.
Oh my.
Are you seriously leaving that?
No!
Okay, I was just wondering.
No, I got a yoke eliminator kit from Rough Country. It'll shrink this up a little bit, and then I have, I believe, an adjustable drive shaft. And it'll lessen the angle probably by about 10-15 degrees. Maybe even more.
That's not even
safe. No, it's not. I'm replacing that.
No, that's not you?
No, that's far from me. Yeah, they just went to town.
Oh my god.
Working on the steering rod mount, or whatever you want to call it, the thing that it
basically holds this thing up. I think what happened was they put a new one in here, and since this has the V6 engine instead of the four cylinder, when they welded this engine mount in there, because that is definitely not factory, I think that mount took this guy's place, but that doesn't matter because this isn't going to be tall enough anyways. So I fabricated a mount and it's right here.
I MIG welded that mount with that welder right there. Now I got the big guns out to do the rest of it. Not because I need big guns, it's because that line isn't long enough and this one is. It's right there. I have the mount tacked up, so now that'll sit just like that. That does it for this 3D Machines production. I know you guys enjoyed it. I tried my best to take what was in my mind and put it out there for you for what I'm thinking right now.
There's only a few more things that I have to weld, like that mount, like the engine mounts.
And a transfer case mount, if it has a transfer case, I don't know. I'm not too familiar with Jeeps, but it just looks wonky how the transmission's mounted there.
But then after that, there's no mounting system. I would say that this piece is aftermarket and it looks pretty strong.
I'll look into that if you guys can help me look into that and leave any like links in the description or just, you know, some comments in the comment section. I would appreciate it.
Also, when it comes to like painting valve covers and like engine components, I would appreciate that as well.
Stay froggy fresh, stay super fly. Until next time, 3D Machines out. Have a froggy fresh day.